Okay, it's not working. That's, let me see. If you want, everybody's standing up, so we gotta do it. I'll hold it up to my mic. You don't want to hear me sing. Just kidding, I'll hold it. Thank you. So, again, I appreciate everybody standing up, because just imagine me on the street corner doing this, I mean, it's pretty exciting. So, here we go. So remember, you're gonna bob to the left, bob to the right, hop, and then we're gonna turn around and we're done. Let me just get to the point. All right, ready? Start. Two. All right, hold on. Oh, come on! Bob to the left, bob to the right, bob to the right, two times.
So even yesterday, come sit on this sideline. So I just want you to hog down on that racket. So what sideline?
Do we like those kind? Do we like kind of listening right now? Nice words. Okay, so we're going to listen first with our eyes. So I think respecting the coach. I think respecting the coach with the eyes is important. I want the kids to be able to see into my eyes, and I want them, and I want to see their eyes. So I never wear sunglasses when I'm with kids, and when I'm talking to them, I'm getting down to their level. So I do a lot of standing up, I do a lot of sitting down, constant. And the reason is, it was amazing. Last week we had a camp, and I'm trying to talk to a player, and this player plays multiple times in the club, and they're still turning around and nodding off while I'm talking. My community programs, there's none of that. Okay? So first we're going to respect with our eyes. Next we're going to respect with our body. So show me again how I asked you to hold the racket. Perfect. Hey Mike, can you just hold that ball for me? Nice. Alright. So then we talk about our bodies. So again, it's turning the body towards the coach. Because I can be here listening this way. Now I want the coach, I want the kids facing me all the time. So I'm going to show you, we're going to do some bop-offs. And then when I say stop, I always have my players turn towards me. And then the last one, who said listening? That was awesome. Why do we want to listen? Why do we want to, how do we, why? What do you think? Would you want someone not to listen to what you have to say? Yeah, and then you listen to what they're going to say. So what you're going to do with your rackets, you can go back and forth with your coach. You're going to take a ball, and you're going to do your self-rallies. And then when I say stop, I want you to turn, have your racket, and show me that respect, okay? All right, so let's do this. Let's go you two with Coach Paul on that side. Run over there. And then we'll keep you five together. All right? So, you're first going to do your bump-ups, okay? And when I say stop, you're going to turn and show that respect that we just practiced. Ready? Go. Okay, here you go. The reason also I think respect is a big thing, because a lot of times, some of the kids that I work with, they don't get these life skills at home. Unless they're living in foster homes, shelters. So they're not getting it there. Somebody has a teacher. Sometimes in the classroom, they're not listening. But there's a reason they're not listening in the classroom. So we can teach them on the tennis court. It's amazing what's going to happen when they go back to the classroom. Now, let's stop. Let's see it. Nice. All right, so now you're going to go for 30 seconds. Coach Rita. Alright. Yeah, you're looking at Coach Butch. So now what I want you to do is you're gonna find a partner. So if I'm with Coach Butch, we're gonna find a target, and we're just gonna do our bump ups over the target, and then when I say respect, you're gonna go. You're gonna stop, right? Ready? So what do you do with three here, Paul? So I have something called the triple A. So the triple A is I keep their attention. Oh, good job. I keep them active and then they're awesome. So that's why I have no discipline in action because they're constantly doing something. Hey guys, where's your target? Yeah. Okay, stop. Where's your ball? Good. So what I try to do also is point out kids that are doing it well. And I try to say, wow, Samuel really looks like a great player. He's respecting, he's remembering those. Let's try to be like Samuel. Okay, you all look great, but that's, you all look perfect. Next, I'm going to go on O, opportunity. So how many of you sometimes wish you had extra hands on the court? A lot of us probably, right? So I try to maximize my ties in the community as much as possible. So I hold hands with my volunteers. I try to find people that just want to help the kids. So I get people that have never played tennis before, and they have to go out there three or four times to train them, but it's all worth it. Here's the jobs. And so what I do is I do stations, and I just give them one or two goals to focus on, and then that's all they have to do, and then that frees me up to run around. So we're going to put in the word opportunity. So what does opportunity mean? Does anybody know? To have a chance to do something. That's great. Does anybody, do you always want a chance to do something? You never do? Yeah, you do sometimes. So we're going to do a little game with four kids on a court. And so it looks like this. I'm going to have a toss in here. I'll demonstrate, okay? So a toss is going to be there. We're going to have a caller right here. A hitter on that Okay. So, you don't need a racket. Ready, go, shot. So, call out the color. Blue.
Blue.
I'm yellow. So, where's blue? Okay, good. All right, so let's see it. Well, you got to catch it. So good. Now, can we coach it up? Let's ask for recovery. So, my head here. Now, let me get you started. 1 second. Okay, let's try this again. Ready? Call out the color. That's okay. So start practicing. I'm going to rotate you. Okay? So let's do it. So Sandra's going to be the hitter. Coach Bush is going to be the caller. I'll hold the ball. Thank you. Thank you. You're going to be the catcher. So here's yellow. And here's blue. All right, Coach Bush, let's hear a color. Oh, you got two coaches. So you'll be the coach, you'll be the caller. Okay, go for it. So this is pretty realistic. And I think sometimes we give up on an activity because it doesn't flow the way we want it to. And so sometimes it takes 2 or 3 minutes to get the girl going. And then it flows and they get it. So here's 8 people on one court. I would put my volunteers probably on this side to help the kids catch. And then I'm roaming on the hitting side, giving those little tips. Okay? So when I rotate. So the tossers are going to go to the hitters. Hitters are going to be the color caller. Color caller are going to be the catchers. The catchers go to the coach. Ready? Let's go. So you're right here. You go to the ways a coach can teach kids how to succeed. It's not easy, but how can we do it? Progression, you got it right. That was my next thing. You got it right on. Okay, so with progression, you have, again, you have to individualize for the kid. You have to meet them where they are. So sometimes I'm doing bump-ups with a kid while one kid is still working on just driving the traffic. So I like to use the game jacks for it, okay? So I'm going to show you what jacks are, and then we'll split up on both sides again. How does that sound? Did you ever grow up playing jacks, any of you? Have you ever seen the game jacks?
No.
All right, I'm going to teach you. So, I went to summer camp. That's why we went there. I learned jack. Coach, did you grow up playing jacks?
A little bit.
All right, so jacks looks like this. The first one was called onesies. So onesies looks like this. I hit it once, I catch it. What comes after one?
Two.
Two, I gotta get twosies. One, two, and I catch. What comes after two?
Three.
So what do you think it's called?
Three.
Threesies. So one, two, three. So I'm gonna give you each your own task, ready? Task. Do you know what that is? Well, you're gonna hear it. You're gonna do pop-ups, what I just did, okay? Okay, can you pull that rack? Oh, okay, well, good. So you're gonna do your pop-ups, okay? Remember, you're gonna know what to do with the bump-up with the partner. You're gonna do with Coach Rita. You two are gonna hit with Coach Butch over the net. And you're gonna hit with Coach Paul over the net. We're gonna go from onesies to tensies. Alright? Onesies to tensies. So let's do it. Butch, you want to do that side? Paul wants to do that side too. So the reason I'm showing you different skills is because I want you to understand that even if you're in a club and you have a group from 5 to 6 year olds, you still have different levels. And I think still we're not to the point of this game, this evolution of using the 10 on a format. You guys can start. Go for it. So one thing first. I think even still, if we try something, it doesn't work, and so we give up. So right now, what I would be doing is I would be going around. Okay, I'm going to go around. So let's do the set. Ready? So we're going to do onesies first. Ready? Go. So you do the onesies. And then catch it. Go. Let it bounce. Catch. Now what are we on?
Twosies.
Ready? Go. One. Two. Catch. Now what? Three. Go. One. Two. Great, so keep going. Let's see, I'm getting successful after we've had trouble. Now we're ready to do a different skill. We're going to flip it. So now we're going one down. We go one up, one down. So watch me, ready? So we're going to go up. Onesies, twosies, threesies, foursies, catch. Go for it. So getting down to their eye level, giving them that encouragement. Not the eye hand, but can you show me? Or, hey, keep that up, let us work. Get them to the next level. Because that's a lot. I mean, life isn't easy. We know that. So we can teach them that it's okay to make mistakes, but they gotta stick with it. How's Coach Rita doing?
You're
the second. You're the second. Right? So children excel. It's in an area called Riverdale in Chicago. They all have my phone number, they all have my email address, and so now they're calling me trying to get dates for this coming year because they want to start, and they just want to make sure that I can come to one. Well, now they're to the point that these mothers who have never played tennis before can now run the programs. They have all the equipment, they have the curriculum that I helped write for them, but they've been out with me for probably a year now so that they feel confident and confident that they can actually run it. And again, it's basic ideas. Now, there was a question that came up a few weeks ago from a coach that Ann was with me, and he said, you know, you get them to a point and then what are you going to do, walk away? Or they can only go so far because there's no money. Well, I look at it like this. There's 30 kids in the program. You give them something. 100% of them are going to get something out of it. Okay? Maybe 5 want to continue. I can find a partnership with a club. That's easy. I think we all can. I think we can go find a club in our area and work with them to let our kids come in. Now, I'm not saying 3. There's definitely going to take. Let's say there's 1 that's ready to go on to play more tournaments. You can find a way to make it work. Like I said, there's, I don't know the word no, and it's, for those of you that really know me, you know that's true. Yes, I have found ways to make this work. And so don't, if you think you can't find a way to get a club to let a player in, then there's another, go in the back door, go in the side door, make a different phone call, because there is a way. Okay, again, you're showing your kids, you want to succeed, you got to work hard for it. You have to find a way to do it. So I think that's important. All right, you ready to play a rally game? Okay, all right, ready to play. So we're going to play the card game. I know you've seen it. I'm going to let them practice with it for a little bit. So the card game looks like this. Have you ever played the card game in New York? How do you play it in New York? So how do you play it in New York if you play the card game? In tennis. How do you play? Yep, we're going to play cards over the ground. So, you're going to be the partner, and if you pull a 5, you got to get 5 shots over the net. Okay. You're going to make a 5 with your cards. If you get a king, you're going to have to hit 10. And what? Aces are 1. There's no joker. I don't think there's any joker. Oh, there is a joker? Not a jack. There's a joker. Now, Jacks are 10. So face card for 10. So Jack, King, King are 10. Pick a coach to play with. Coach Rita, was it two girls? Alright. Yeah, take your time. Okay. Fall. Who wants to be the coach? Coach Bush and I need to be partners.
Okay.
And then you two are partners. So everybody go around the court. Run down to the court. So I'm going to let them play with you. You see it, and then I'm going to show you again the number 8 to do skills. But you're just watching me coach Paul. Can you just glass and have it?
Wait, give me just a second.
All right. So when I say go, the youngest player on your court has to run and get a card. So the youngest card has to run and get a card. So, Dylan, move over. Coach Bush, you know how to do that?
Okay.
You just have to practice the bowling. Okay? For those of you who know, you can bowl. All right? Over here, what we're going to work on is both of us, both of you are going to work on track. Okay? The track looks like this. The coach falls into me. And I'm going to trap it. And I'm going to do a drop it back and fall into the track. Okay? You two are going to hit it. This side, you're going to try to keep it, see this blue line? You're going to try to keep it from inside the blue line and this white box. You're going to see it right here. Do you need a big stroke or a small stroke? Okay, ready? So still the car game, you've got to do, you're going to use your new skill. Ready? Go. So again, same game, four different ways. So you can come in any out, you can come in any class, any after school program, and have a plan. So you have to be willing to adjust your plan based for it. So every time I come to the plan, I'm constantly changing it depending on the skill. You are super fast. Come on.
Ten.
Go.
How many coaches are you
getting?
Okay? 64 plus 36. 146. 100 plus. So how many did you get? 118. Pretty good in like 2 minutes, right? Good job.
Every time you say I was saying.
Okay. We have to have videos of all this if you want to see it.
He's taking a beat.
If you have kids that only play the gym, that are taking the classes and have the preparation, there's no way.